This is the brand new modular scope from Askar, the Askar V. This scope comes with two different objective lenses, a focal reducer, a field flattener, and a focal extender. In this video, we are doing a full review. Hopefully, we can answer all the questions you may have in regards to the Askar V. In this video, we're going to discuss a few things. First, we're going to show you how to configure the scope and its different objective lenses and its focal reducers, flatteners, and focal extenders, how to put those together. Then we're going to talk about the different focal lengths that each combination achieves. I plan on going out under a clear sky and taking a photo with the shortest focal length possible with a full frame camera. From there, we can crop down that photo to help represent the fields of view that you may get if you use the 60 or the 80 millimeter objective with the reducer, the flattener, or the focal extender. And then we're going to get into what combination of objective lens and reducer, flattener, and focal extender works with small mounts such as the Skywatcher GTI. So let's go ahead and get started with configuration. So the scope comes out of the box with the 80 millimeter objective already attached. To remove the 80 millimeter and to replace it with the 60, you want to slide the dew shield all the way upwards and twist the lens itself following the arrows. It should thread off rather easily, and from here you can replace it with the 60 millimeter objective lens. Now attaching the field flattener, the reducer, and the extender is standard, just like it is on most refractors. You want to remove the visual adapter on the very back of the scope and then remove the cap from the back of the reducer. The reducer then threads in place of the visual adapter. The camera side of the reducer also has a cap that reveals M48 threads, and you want to follow the same exact process for the extender and the flattener. The assembly and the disassembly of the scope is extremely easy, but I want to talk more about the reducer, the flattener, and the focal extender. We're going to combine this section in with the specifications of the telescope, since the specs are constantly changing depending on what components are installed. But all differences aside, the 60mm and the 80mm objective lens are in fact both triplets. Another important thing to note is that on the reducer, the flattener, and the extender, they are both marked to match the objective lens that you are using. Be sure to correctly set these parameters given your objective lens. So with that being said, let's take a look at all the different focal length combinations possible with the Askar V. I spent a night collecting data with the 60mm objective lens installed, along with the focal reducer. This gave me the shortest possible focal length of 270mm, and this was paired with the largest supported camera sensor, the ASI 6200MC, giving me the largest possible field of view. Now, with the field of view at 270mm and the 6200MC, we can deduce what the other possible fields of views may look like when using the other combination of optics. Let's take a look at these other fields of view. So again, this photo was taken with the 60mm objective lens and the focal reducer, giving me a focal length of 270mm, and this was captured on a 6200 full frame color CMOS camera. This next crop down represents the 60mm objective with the flattener at a focal length of 360mm focal length. The next widest field of view is the 80mm objective with the reducer at 384mm focal length. A very similar field of view to the 60mm objective and the flattener, with just 24mm difference in focal length. Now, because these fields of view are so similar, we just recommend that you use the 80mm objective and the reducer rather than the 60mm objective with the field flattener. This way you get more light gathering power and more resolution at a faster focal ratio. The next crop down represents the 60mm with the extender at 446mm of focal length. Following this, you have the 80mm with the flattener at 495mm. Finally, we have the 80mm objective with the extender at 600mm focal length. This is a perfect candidate to medium-sized galaxy and nebulae. So now that we have a better understanding of the different fields of view that you can create with the Askar V and a full-frame camera, let's talk about image quality. Let's take a look at the photo that I captured of M8 and M20 using the focal reducer. A focal reducer doesn't typically correct as well as a standard field flattener, so it may be best here to not expect perfectly corrected results all the way to the edge of the frame, but rather permissible results. Now, I've seen a lot of tests with this scope using an APS-C size sensor, and the stars even then are a tad oblong, but I have yet to see this scope paired with a full frame camera. Let's take a look at a single subframe. Here is the Lagoon and Trifid Nebula, a single 4 minute sub exposure. When you zoom into the center and look at the quality of the stars, you can see that they are perfectly round. As you zoom out and then back into the corners, you can see that at the very far edges, they are a little bit oblong. But as I mentioned, this is somewhat to be expected with a focal reducer and a focal ratio of f4.5 with a full frame camera. This is not drastically different from what we see with other refractors with reducers. Now you have to really be pixel peeping to tell that the stars at the very far edges of the frame are a little bit oblong. In addition, it's likely that the stars look near perfect with the flattener or focal extender at f6 or f7. But when you look at the final image as a whole, you cannot help but just be impressed. A major question that may be asked by a lot of beginner astrophotographers is, will this scope work with a small mount like the StarVenture GTI? I weighed each component of the Askar V, including my imaging train, which includes a 533 mono, a filter wheel, a guide camera, and an off-axis guider. I really wanted to see which combinations would work and which wouldn't with the StarVenture GTI. So I have concluded the following. So first off, any combination of components that you use with the 60mm objective lens should work with the GTI. You should have a focal length short enough and you're under that 11-pound payload capacity, so you shouldn't have any problems. Now, secondly, the scope with the 80mm objective lens and the focal reducer may work. You are hitting that 11.36 pound mark from what I gathered, but the focal length is rather wide. You're just a little bit heavy and just a tad over that payload capacity of the GTI. And lastly, the 80mm with the extender or the field flattener will likely not give you consistent results. It's just a little too heavy and the focal length is just a little too long. Upwards of 600mm is really pushing the GTI. Now, we have not actually tested these out in the field. Hopefully we get the chance to do that, and if we do, we will be sure to let the community know the results that we achieve. So that is it for this review. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you have any questions about the Askar V, this is going to be a scope that we likely work with in the future. So any questions you have, we would be more than happy to answer in the comments below. If you haven't liked this video, please like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel so you do not miss any future content over astronomy and astrophotography. Thank you so much, and clear skies.